back for the second half of tonight's action, Vermont at Niagara University. And after 20 minutes, we're all knotted up at 35-35. I'm Lou Panessa along with Mike Jankowski to call the second half of tonight's action. And Mike, it seemed that Niagara ran a good offense as Andy Walker looks over the stats. But defensively, they were a little bit lax in the first half, and it really cost them. Vermont was getting good shot opportunities and cashed in often enough, even though they only shot 46% in the first half.
Well, that's really been the case in most of the games this year. Defense really hurting the Eagles. Vermont shooting better than expected, actually, 13 to 28 from the floor for 46%. Niagara, on the other hand, 13 to 29, 44%. Free throws, Niagara, 8 of 9 to Vermont's 6 of 9. Turnovers the same at 6. Rebounds pretty even, although Niagara's got 3 more than the Catamonts, 18 to 15. Each team with 5 offensive rebounds. Pat Jones did not play the last 10 minutes of the first half, I believe. Wound up leading scorer Niagara with 11 points. A couple people with 4 each. Henry and Carl Hare, Brevard with 6, Mike Rios with 5. For Vermont, Kenny White, the freshman guard from Staten Island, 4 of 7. From the floor, 12 points, 3 players each with 4. Kurt Kappas, Joe Calavito, only 4, 1 for 7 from the floor. Raheem Hulanel, 4 points also.
Vermont fired up 9 three-point field goal attempts. Kenny White threw up 5 of them. They were 3 of 9 from three-point land. And I don't think we'll see any drop-off in that number in the second half. Not going to complain about the officiating tonight. As we mentioned, Mike, one of the best in the business. A man who's done Final Four games in the NCAA tournament. Henry Nichols officiating tonight's game as part of the crew. For the second half, Niagara will start Mark Henry, Tony Francis, and Pat Jones up front. Mike Rios and Derek Brevard at the guards. Vermont will have Joe Calavita at center. At the forwards, Kevin Roberson and Raheem Hulanel. The guards are number 32, White, and 35, Donovan.
Some type of discrepancy at the bench. Timeouts. TV timeouts.
I didn't recall asking for any.
Radio timeouts.
We do this just for fun. Actually, if you're watching on Friday night, stay tuned after tonight's game, Buffalo Sabres hockey. Key Adams Division matchup, Sabres taking on the Montreal Canadiens. Derek Brevard picks up a loose ball after Niagara turned it over, and they'll have another opportunity. They try to go to Pat Jones. Ball is knocked away. Brevard returned his errant's pass. Retrieved, I guess, is the proper word. Niagara goes inside again. Pat Jones backing his way in. Now puts the shot up.
Basket by Jones.
Jones really been open all night.
He's been able to score at will when he's posted up down low. Niagara. And man-to-man along the baseline, and that's why Pat Jones sat out the last 10 minutes of the first half, as Roberson just goes right by him for a bucket.
Roberson didn't do a whole lot the first half, played 12 minutes, had a couple personals and 1 rebound. That's his first field goal of the game.
Henry with the ball, Jones posting up again. Rios, now Jones with it. Brings it back out to Rios, fakes a three-pointer, goes in the lane, and his shot is good.
Basket by Rios.
Mike now at 7.
2-point Purple Eagle lead. That's L. Pass almost goes out of bounds, saved by Roberson. Now they try and trap L. And he pulls it back out to White. Kenny White, been a big spark plug for Vermont tonight. Calavita's not doing the offensive load. Now he gets the ball inside. It's blocked by Mark Henry. Back to Calavita and lays it in.
By Calavita.
Calavita was only 1 of 7 in the first half for Vermont. But still, they were tied at halftime. 35 all and remain tied now. 39. Brevard all the way in. Shot goes in and out, and Calavita picks up a foul.
That's his second.
Fouls charged to number 25, Joe Calavita. His second.
First foul for either team
Vermont's
this half.
First team foul, number 10, Derek Brevard, on the line, shooting two.
Brevard looking for points number 7 and 8.
Too strong with that one. And again too strong. Rebound controlled by Roberson. Now Niagara goes to a 2-3 zone. Donovan to Calavita. Calavita from up top takes it inside and scores.
Calavita now with 8, matching his total against Niagara of about 2 weeks ago.
Vermont grabs the lead. They started off in the lead 5-0, but then Niagara in 3 minutes took the lead and hadn't trailed again until now. 17-23 remaining in the game. Purple Eagles down by 2. Niagara working the perimeter, waiting for a cutter. Pat Jones comes through, dishes back to Rios from 3.
Basket by Rios. 3 points.
Rios joining Pat Jones in double figures now with 10.
Donovan drives, gives to Calavita. The ball's knocked away. Mark Henry gets the steal. And Rios will slow it down. Niagara up by 1 after Rios' last three-pointer, 42-41. Working on the 2-3 zone of Vermont. Barn goes inside to Jones on Calavita. His shot off balance, no good. Francis tips it up. Loose ball. Francis along the baseline saves it to Jones. And he pulls it back out to Rios. Good work underneath by Tony Francis. Jones in the lane to Rios. Fakes a three-pointer, drives, dishes off. Brevard from 3. Off the rim, no good. Rebound, Francis up, no good. Jones has got it, and he gets it in.
Three offensive rebounds by Niagara during that possession.
Niagara pounding the offensive glass. That gets Andy Walker excited. They lead at 44-41. And a quick substitution for Tom Brennan. He wants Chris Kappas back in there for rebounding streak. And right away, Kenny White, the man of the night for Vermont, nails a three-pointer.
White with 15.
That's his third three-point field goal. Jones, triple team, gets it to Rios. Now they work it to Henry, free shot.
Basket by Henry.
Good job offensively for Niagara. They collapsed on Jones and they found the open man in the form of Mark Henry for the bucket. 46-44. The Eagles lead. Now see if they can stop him. Calavita, shot is blocked by Henry. Back to him and a foul.
Henry's second, Niagara's first of this half.
Fouls charged to number 24.
Twice Mark Henry has blocked shots by Joe Calavita, only to see Calavita retrieve the block and go back up with
Niagara's
it.
Niagara's first team foul.
And now he goes to the line.
24, Chris Kempis in the lineup for Vermont. 25 is Joe Calavita.
Calavita, an excellent free throw shooter for big man, 80 of 97, 82.5%.
Calavita was a preseason conference player of the year as judged by the Sporting News. And last year, of course, he was redshirted after suffering that stress fracture in his left leg. Missed the second one, but I believe we're going to have a lane violation.
Mike Rios in far too early.
Kenny White really having an outstanding night tonight for Vermont, but he was in a terrible slump coming into this game, only 5 of 31 in his last three games, and tonight he's turned it around.
Number in the Niagara University Cheerleader Split Club, 194.
Game is tied at 46 all with 15:26 remaining. There you see LD Moore in the small cast on his hand. Still about 4 weeks away before LD could start to play again.
Yeah, it was initially 6 weeks. I still think it's at 6 weeks. It'll be end of February. Maybe the playoffs. Maybe. Maybe the last week of the regular season. It's one of those situations where they don't know until you get the cast taken off.
If it would be nice, I'm sure Niagara would like to see him come back at the end of the regular season to get himself into playing shape before the playoffs begin in the conference.
Sure, it'll be difficult after not having played for 5 or 6 weeks. Awful lot of conditioning that these players go through.
Check your program book.
Practice day in and day out, 2.5-3 hours a day. It certainly takes a lot of preparation. And once you lose that mental toughness and endurance, it's difficult to get it back.
Looking at Tom Brennan, the head coach of Vermont, just a moment ago, and he has worked under Villanova's Raleigh Massimino, Penn State's Bruce Parkhill, and former Seton Hall under Bill Rafferty before coming to Vermont. He's also a head coach at Yale before he came here. Likes to dance around. You'll see him pull a few antics on the sidelines before the night's over. Brevard inside, a little hook's good. Eric Brevard snuck inside and the little guard nails one. 48-46, Niagara pressing again. Calavita at half court, brings it across himself. And that's White with the ball, guarded by Rios. Jones posting in front of Kappas. Now they set a pick to get Calavita free and Francis sticks with him. Kappas comes around the screen, his shot is off the mark, tipped out. Jones with the rebound. 2-on-2 for Niagara. Jones and Rios. Jones loses the handle. And so Mike Rios will pull it back out. Jones back out to Rios. Fakes the three-pointer, goes to Jones. Mark Henry back into Jones, playing catch in there. Jones goes, turns around, too long. Francis tips it up and gets the ball, brings it back out to Rios. And he'll pull it back out with a fresh shot clock.
Nice play by Tony Francis.
Tony's really done a good job inside tonight, rebounding and boxing out for Niagara. Mark Henry alley-loops it to Jones. Calavita helps out, but Jones hits it.
Patrick with 17.
There's Tom Brennan. 50-46. Kenny White brings it across, and he's going to go along the baseline. Now a pass to Calavita. In and out. And they tip it up. Kappas comes down with it. His shot. No, it's a pass to Calavita, who's fouled by Brevard.
Had three Eagles on Calavita that time.
And as everybody followed Calavita, Kappas came down with the ball.
Derek Brevard.
Had about a 5-foot shot and elected to pass to Calavita. Calavita wasn't expecting it. Brevard came around the backside and fouled him.
Brevard now with two fouls, and Niagara two this half. Calavita looking for his 11th and 12th points.
Calavita featured, there you see Carl Hare on the Niagara bench. Carl came out limping, I noticed, in the warm-ups for the second half. It remains to be seen whether or not we'll see him in the second half tonight. One-point game. Niagara in the lead, unable to shake the Catamounts here on their home floor. Now Vermont switches to a surprise defense for them, man-to-man. They don't play a lot of man-to-man. Derek Brevard is free for the jumper. In and out, Tony Francis along the glass, picks it up, and Calavita sends it to the corner. And White will bring it up. Cross court all alone, Ruulandale, shot is blocked by Henry. Jones strips Calavita, and Niagara comes the other way. 3-on-2, Rios to Brevard, to the basket, and he's fouled.
Foul by Bart Donovan, his second. Good foul in that situation. It was a 3-on-1.
Fouls charged to number 32, Kenny White.
Brian,
his third. Fouls on White.
Vermont's second team foul.
That's the third foul on White, second team foul on the Catamounts. Brian Bleach will
Derek
come in
Brevard
at the first opportunity.
Line,
Brevard missed his last two free throws. And makes the adjustment there.
Derek now with 9.
In and out on the second one, Kappas with the rebound. It's 51-48. Pull-up shot is good.
Basket by
Ulan L.
He's had a quiet game.
Another person who's really dropped off from last year, as I mentioned earlier, Ulan L. was the leading scorer. Off the hands of Pat Jones, he gets loose balls, White loses it back, and then he travels.
Traveling violation.
you had that ball on the floor, it just seems that a lot of travels occur down there as you shuffle your feet.
Derek Brevard to the bench, Bleach in.
Niagara going with a bigger lineup now. Mark Henry will play the other guard with Mike Rios. Shot from 3-point off the range. Out of bounds, Niagara's ball.
Green ball.
No, he changed it back to green ball. He pointed first in Niagara's direction, but now they'll keep it there.
Eagles were in a 1-3-1 at that point.
Again, three. Look at the Vermont bench. Everybody put up the 3-point field goal sign as White was so wide open in the corner, and he nailed it. His fourth 3-pointer. And now Niagara's down by two, 53-51, 12-12 remaining. 1-3-1 from Vermont. Rios is free from three. It goes in and out, and the loose ball is picked up by Kappas, and the foul will go against Bleach as he collided with Kappas.
Tough call.
Both men going for the ball, and Bleach picked up the foul. Andy Walker wanted a travel call.
Bleach's second foul, and Niagara's third.
Niagara's third team foul.
And Vermont with their third lead of the game and the ball now. They go inside. Calavita. Shot is blocked by Henry. Gets it right back. Basket and a foul. Tony Francis is fronting Calavino. Mark Henry's giving backside help. Henry has blocked the shot three times. Calavita's come down with it three times and has gone back up with it.
Tony Francis.
Francis really doing a good job rebounding, too. As I mentioned, beforehand, we knew he was going to have his hands full, and Calavita's really awakened the second half. Now at 15.
55-51, Vermont with a 4-point lead, 11:52 remaining, and another official's timeout. I make that 56-51. That matches their biggest lead of the game when they jumped out 5-0 in the early going. And it's been a two-man story for the Catamounts. Kenny White with 4 3-pointers. And now in the second half, Joe Calavita picking up the offensive production after a slow first half.
They've combined for 33 points. White with 18. He had 12 after the first 20 minutes of play. Calavita with 15. He only had 4 at halftime. And they're going to him more often this half than they did in the last half. Had a horrendous shooting performance in that opening 19 minutes that he played. He was 1 for 7. Certainly come alive at this juncture. And as I mentioned, they're looking more and more for him.
And you can just see the frustration on Mark Henry's face, especially after that last sequence that Calavita got the bucket and the foul for a 3-point play, because three consecutive times he has blocked Calavita's shot, and Calavita has come right back down with it for an easy for return shot. And it's just, you could just see the frustration on Henry's face.
4-1-6.
Vermont drops back and allows Niagara to bring it up freely. And they go to a strange defense there, kind of like a 1-1-3. Mark Henry gets free, shot's way short. L with the rebound, Hulan L. Henry steals the ball, knocks it away, and saves it. Mike Rios to Bleach, nice pass and a bucket. Niagara down by three. White brings it up on Rios. Gives off to Kappas at the top of the key. Now L's free. He's off the mark, Tony Francis rebound. And what do we got here? Could be on Calavita.
Ball's charged to number 25.
It is.
Calavita.
That's his third.
His third. It's Vermont's third team foul. Substitution, number 35, Bart Donovan, back in the lineup for Vermont.
And with the ball cross court, Bleach is free, and he's good.
Basket by Bleach.
Niagara back within one, 56-55.
Consecutive huge baskets by Brian Bleach.
Freshman coming through here for Niagara. And looking inside to Calavita, nothing there. They go outside to Roberson and work around the perimeter. That's White with it now. Again, Tony Francis fronting Calavita. The backside help now is from Pat Jones. There it is, inside. Bleach comes up with the loose ball.
Looks like they've tried to go in a well once too often here.
Niagara almost in a double-team situation with Calvita. Bleach will try again. No good. Box out that time by Roberson, gets the rebound. Buffalo product from Hutch Tech. White all alone from three, short with it. Rebound to Pat Jones. Vermont hustles back on defense, and Rios wisely holds on to the ball. Now Pat Jones against Calavita. Good. Hey, Calavita, as great an offensive performer as he's not a defensive superstar. Pat Jones giving away a lot of, as he points a finger at, Calavita points a finger at Jones, they have a few words. Pat Jones is giving away quite a few inches to Calavita, four or five as a matter of fact, and Jones is able to muscle inside and score on
it. Well, Calavita in a situation, too, where he's got three fouls and has to be a little careful. He's been the bulk of their offense the second half. Jones now with 19, Kenny White 18, Calavita 15. One other player in double figures, Mike Rios with 10.
As far as shot blocking for the Catamounts, Roberson is second in the North Atlantic Conference in that category, averaging better than 2.5 a game. So they look for the inside help from him.
Out with Eagle is celebrating her 5th birthday today. Happy birthday, Bonnie.
Applause for Bonnie, a Niagara University cheerleader. Yeah, that's her. 5 years old.
Freshman.
Must have had some great SAT scores. Speaking about SATs, 20, Vermont's a team that prides themselves on putting some academic people out there. Even to walk in the door and play ball at Vermont, you have to have at least 1,000 on the SATs. Now, of course, NCAA just asks you to have 700. They upped the ante by 300 to play on the Vermont team. They bring it back out. Lubis with the ball, gives it off to White. In the corner now, free campus to Calavita. And Tony Francis got a hand on him.
I think he got more than a hand on that one.
Well, he wasn't the only one.
That's Francis' second. Niagara's fifth.
Niagara's fourth team foul. Number 25, Joe Calavita.
Calavita making a living at the free throw line here in the second half.
Freddie Caso said it's Niagara's fourth, so I'll reserve judgment. Really awkward shot. I kind of get a kick out of that. That's
it's all wrist action. But he's pretty successful.
Not too easy to wrist the ball that far from that position.
And it's really one-handed, too. He takes the second hand away. Tony Francis comes down with the rebound with Pat Jones. Pat gives way. Rios brings it up. Tie game, 9-11 remaining. Niagara works the rotation. Rios on the penetration gives to Henry. They wait for Pat Jones to cut three for the inside shot. There's Jones with it now to Rios, who's got some room. His shot, no, he gives it off to Bleach, turns it over. Loose ball, Rios has got it. Back to Henry inside the three-point line.
Mark with eight.
Playing with a little bit of a flu virus, Mark Henry starting to produce offensively now. Campus gets the ball knocked away by Henry. Francis goes to the floor, and it's going to be Vermont ball.
Vermont ball.
Niagara trapping Vermont. And, you know, as much as Niagara has applied pressure, I think if they really intensified it a bit, Niagara just...
You're right on the edge, yeah.
Yeah, Vermont doesn't look like they're that confident handling the ball. Pick that little note up from Dave Kerner from WEBR, standing courtside with us.
By Calavita.
You can listen to him on News Radio 970. $59 all.
He's passing me the $5 to give to you.
Pat Jones tied up by Calavita, but he gets it away to Bleach. Francis to Rios. Niagara had four players out near three-quarter court line for a second there. Henry will pull up for the jumper. It's short, and the rebound picked up by Kappas. White pushes it up. Donovan, now Lubas. Guarded by Henry to Kappas. They bring it back to White. White will set it up. And it's no secret. They're going to try and free up Calavita on the inside. Calavita going against Tony Francis. And Henry and Bleach to help out whenever possible. There it is. Inside, Calavita.
Basket by Calavita.
He's a load to stop.
With 20.
61-59, Vermont leads it.
Sean Chiano going to try his luck.
Rios will try a bomb. Calavita rebounds. Up quickly, Donovan pulls up for the jumper. It's too long. Pat Jones with the rebound, tries to dribble it out, and pulls back. Andy Walker wants a tempo set here from Rios. Kind of a 2-3 variation zone defense from Vermont. It's not an honest 2-3. More like a 1-1-3 or a 1-4. They said they play a lot of junk defense. That's Jones inside, back out to Rios. Shot from there last time, not this time, gives to Bleach. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Rios will try to drive. He penetrates,